All right. Farhan, Richa, may I request all of you to please. मेरी आवाज ऐसी है ना, मेरी हर बार बोलते हैं सब, कोई बोलता है तू डरा देता है यार, बैठ जाओ बच्चों, बैक बेंचेस वहां पे पीछे बातें कर रहे हैं तो मुझे बुलाना पड़ा कि थैंक यू. ऑलराइट जय, आई एम गोइंग टू क्विकली चेक विद जय इफ ऑल ओके. नाउ एनीबॉडी वाटर?
थैंक यू.
H2O एनीबॉडी? श्योर, गुड. थैंक यू. समराइज द फैंडम अराउंड इनसाइड एज. Yeah, sharing is caring, please. Thank you.
You want to know about the game behind the game.
Yes, and the fandom, the craze.
Nice, Aparna, nice.
You know, for us at Amazon, everything is customer backwards. Customers are really at the front and center of all the decisions that we make. And the fact that we are launching season 3 is a testament to the fact that the show has received so much love and adulation.
Woo!
So much fandom around it. It's really become a part of the cultural zeitgeist of this country.
And I'm one of the crazy consumers who's loved it. So thank you so much for bringing in another season. Wishing you guys all the best, and especially you.
Without you, yeah.
Yeah, tum. Well, Farhan, as we say that a great dish has a secret sauce. What's that special secret when it comes to making a show like Inside Edge, which has resonated so well with the audiences in India and beyond, spanning three seasons or third season coming up?
Well, the secret sauce is the perfect mix and the perfect balance of cricket and entertainment. You know, this country loves its cricket. This country loves its entertainment on screen. And Inside Edge brings those two together perfectly. You know, so I mean, there's drama, there's thrill, there's sporting action. So the entire kind of up and down and emotional upheaval and disappointment that it can bring when you're watching a game. And some really, really fantastically written characters and character arcs. So I feel it is engaging for audiences across all ages, across all genders. And that's what really, really makes it tick. I mean, the fact, like Aparna just mentioned, that we are in season 3 is really a testament in itself. You know, that people have enjoyed this world, have enjoyed these characters, they are wanting to see more. Unfortunately, the lockdown didn't allow us to show it to them a little bit earlier than we would have liked. You know, but here we are, and now that things are coming back to normal, we hope that you will enjoy this the way you've enjoyed the first two.
Yeah, and each and every element as well, every character that we are hooked on to. Thank you for bringing us this superb dish called the Inside Edge. And thank you for bringing
it. Thank you so much, man. It was just for you.
I love you. Thank you, Farhan. Karan, tell us a bit about the theme of season 3 of Inside Edge and how the show has sort of grown under your stewardship.
Right, like I mentioned earlier, like this is the, you know, the most complex and satisfying season that we had a lot of fun writing. We've really expanded the scope of it. Cricket is obviously, now we're talking about test cricket, which is, you know, the epitome of the sport in many ways. It takes a lot of character to play test cricket and to stay at the crease. And similarly, I think, you know, the characters here have peaked in this season. So we have all the women taking center stage. They're just moved into the foreground. They're the ones who are just calling the shots and you know, elevating. We've elevated them into positions where the everything else sort of falls to the wayside. And it's not just Zarina's character or Shayoni's character, but just every single person, every female character that we have on the show is now in a position of power. And that's something we had always planned to do going forward for the first three seasons. We are also looking into the politics behind cricket and a completely fun, fictional take on what could have been or what is happening. And there's also what goes on, the dirty business behind broadcast rights and things. So we've just, you know, picked up things and just gone to town with, you know, in terms of fictionalizing the wild side of it. So that's a few of the themes. It's fiction.
Well played, Karan. Well played.
Farhan wants to...
No, if I just may say, while Karan was very, very sweetly and sincerely answering his question, Richa's giving him reviews from the side of every point. Well said. Good. Yes. Fantastic.
Well played.
Now you know what shoot is like.
Well, thank you so much and wish you all the best. But Kanishk, as we've seen in this face-off between Vayu and Rohit, how important is the aspect of rivalry in season three, and how have you tried pushing the envelope with the show's third installment from a creative storytelling point of view?
Well, I think rivalry in any form of drama is paramount. You know, you look at any film or show, you know, be it Rush or Ford versus Ferrari, like two people wanting the same thing, the rivalry is damn important. So even same thing for Insiders. I think everyone, be it like Vayu Rohit, be it what Zarina wants versus Vikrant Dhawan, there are some other aspects of rivalry as well, which of course we'll keep it for 3rd December for people to watch. But it has added a lot more drama. So I think it's been a very important aspect of the storytelling point of view for Inside Season 3. And as far as creative, I just feel, you know, because this was Season 3, and there's already a set boundary for the show, the drama. So it wasn't like we were trying to create something new. I did on certain aspects, of course, with Mr. Karan Anshuman's permission, and I had to really beg him a lot to kind of do certain things that I wanted to do, which he was absolutely encouraging about. So we did push the cricket, I would say, because it was test, and the first two seasons were like T20. So there's a lot of different style, you know, the game becomes different, right? I mean, you got like defensive and more like pure like cricket per se. So there is where I feel that I was really excited to push the boundary, because I've played the sport myself and I wanted to give it my all. We really sat a lot on the cricket, you know, each ball. We made something like a playbook wherein we broke down each ball. All the guys here rehearsed it. It was like 2 months of rehearsal on how you break down an action sequence or a dance sequence. So, I mean, I really feel the drama is, of course, insane. It's gone up, not just from like the previous two seasons, but I really feel the cricket also has come a long way. And I really hope everybody feels the same way. You know, we enjoyed making it. I don't know about Tanuj and Akshay, because they were like, in Pune, in that heat, almost fainted. Vayu almost fainted, by the way. Like, these guys gave it their all. And I just hope you all, so everybody enjoys it as much as we like enjoyed making it.
So the experience is going to be bigger and better this time with season three.
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
Thank you. Thank you. Vivek, Vikrant has seen so much happening in front of his eyes. Now, what do we expect? What is something new from Vikrant onto the table or onto the stadium or off the stadium this time?
Well, I think in, you know, when Karan shared season three, the script, I read it and I called him back, and I remember and this is going to sound like a plug, but it's not. I was totally at a loss of words. I was like, damn, this is so good. To me personally, and I think a lot of us will agree here, I think that Inside Edge Season 3 is the best season yet. What do you guys think?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah? I feel that with Vikrant, I mean, he's such a powerful character, and he's seen that, you know, that success, that failure, the betrayal, and he's kind of rising back from the ashes. You know, he's kind of that phoenix rising back from the ashes, that wounded tiger on the hunt. And I love that about him in this season. I love that this means so much to him, even personally, because for the first time in three seasons, you get to see what makes Vikrant who he is. Because somebody who's that extreme always has some sort of an extreme experience going on behind it. So you get to see the man behind the mask. You get to see why he's the way he is and why this is all so important to him. So I think fans of Inside Edge and fans of Vikrant Dhawan, people who've been excited and hitting me up on social media, are going to be able to see a whole different side to Vikrant Dhawan, which I'm really excited about.
I would say, okay, bhai saab. Wish you all the best for that. Richa,
you missed the pause.
I missed the pause. Yeah.
There's got to be a deep, pregnant pause. It's going to be like, okay.
Okay.
Pause. Bhai saab. And then okay. little chin nod, maybe. Yeah.
Okay. Bhai saab.
Brilliant. I'm seriously feeling insecure right now.
Thank you. Richa, you've been a part of the season since the first season. What is it that keeps Zarina going?
Zarina?
Zarina.
Zarina. So, I guess revenge. She's quite, she started off as somewhat of a naive character in season one. In season two, she had shades of gray. And in season three, I think she will have fully formed shades of gray that she thinks are white. And I think sometimes, you know, some kind of, you know, revenge is a lazy form of grief, they say. So I think she's somewhat sad and hurt about what had happened in the past. So she's trying to, I see you nodding, Tanu. she's very focused on getting what she wants. She feels she's been wronged, and that keeps Zarina going. What keeps me going with this show is I'm tremendously excited about the format. I remember when this show first came to me, I felt really fortunate, but also everybody around me told me, ke, are web series, hi, 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 career khatam ho gaya, all that. I want to ask where, anyway, so I'm just saying, for me, this show really perfectly bridged the gap between what the urban Indian wanted to watch. And, you know, maybe not everybody can relate to Saas Bahu, no offense. And not everybody wants to only watch international content that is dubbed in. So this provided something to a whole class of people that were neither here nor there. So I'm really excited about the format, about what the OTT space is doing for the industry, what the writing of series is like with book adaptations and so many things happening now. And I think as an actor also, it's really fun to get to, I'm not who I was 6 months ago. So why does Zarina also doesn't have to be who she was a year ago, you know? And that journey is very exciting for me.
So the different layers of Zarina is what we're going to look forward to in season three, yes, as well.
Zarina is Kanda.
Zarina is?
Onion.
The peeling of the layers.
Oh, peeling of the layers.
High
fund
hai thoda. Sorry
for the joke that didn't quite land. Inside edge mein se bouncer kahenge na.
Googly.
Thank you so much, but thank you and wishing you all the best. And Shayani, you're always super excited.